Hello there, Internet's version 2 here with Let's Play Donkey Kong Country 2. And today we're going into the second level of the game, Main Brace Mayhem, which takes aboard a pirate ship. Something I don't think I mentioned this last video. This entire game is basically themed around the idea of pirates. So anyway, we've got Dixie Kong. She spins her hair back and forth like this. Her main ability, which Donkey Kong does not have, helicopter tail twirl. She can glide through the air using her hair, because she is that awesome. And it's a very, very, very frequently used feature, because there's a lot of things that you can only do with her. It's never completing a level, but a lot of the bonuses require you to have it. Anyway, so we've got our first bonus level. Again, bonuses at the beginning of the game, usually pretty easy. There's not too many bonuses in the game that are actually hard, like the actual bonuses themselves. Some are pretty difficult, but most are just average. Some bonuses in the game, however, though, are a righteous pain in the ass to actually get to. But we'll get to those when we get to those. That is quite a while away before we get to those. Anyway, I apologize for not explaining like everything that you see in this game, but I couldn't be bothered. Like, that's just not my style, like, to explain what everything does, because, quite frankly, I'm lazy. So we'll just get those bananas. Oh, you'll also see I've been collecting, sometimes, banana coins. They're tiny little coins that have bananas on them, yeah, as opposed to the big creme coins that you get from bonuses. You use those to purchase certain things, like these here. You use them to purchase certain things from Cranky Kong and his shop, and from Wrinkly Kong at her shop. Wrinkly Kong, by the way, is Cranky Kong's wife. You actually get to see her in this game. It's pretty awesome. So we're gonna go along here, drop down here, just to kill these two. But before we continue anywhere else, we're gonna go up here, and extra 2 lives. This game is abundant with lives, which, based on some of the later levels, you will need. Something I should point out, there is a whole trilogy of, it doesn't matter too much. There's a whole trilogy of Donkey Kong Country games. This, Donkey Kong Country 2, by far my favorite out of the lot. I think it's got the best level design, I think it's got the most interesting levels, most interesting bonuses and stuff like that, best art style, best characters you play as, and just overall, very awesome. And I'm screwing this up already. So this is another destroy them all. We can use a cannonball though, because we're awesome like that. Nah. Come on, you're in the face! And hell yeah, another crumb coin. It's already a 4. And we just run off the edge. Poor guys. They just ran straight off the edge. Didn't even think twice about it. I feel sorry for them now. Kinda. There we go. And we've got our team throw like this, which you can use to throw up. If they land on a higher platform, you can land on there, or you can use them to attack by throwing them forward. But if they don't hit anything, they start crying like they've died. But you can just go pick them up and it'll all be good again. And here we are for our third bonus of the level. Yeah, I'm correct. Yeah, we're going 3. Here's our first collect stars, which is basically what it says. Just collect as many stars as you can. And I've already missed some down here. Again, because it's the beginning of the game, not too difficult. Down. Just don't want to hit. Just make sure you don't want to. Just make sure you don't fall off the edge at the or fall off the bottom, because that would be, you know, death. That's one of the biggest differences in this game, probably. Previous game, 100% you only need to enter a bonus room, and whatever you did in there didn't matter. Here, it actually means something. Anyway, jumping across here to get our DK coin, and we're just gonna jump down here. Boom! For some reason, we land on there, and we get a life. And we're rocking out the beatbox. Anyway, that's another quick level done. Let's go visit the Monkey Museum, which is Cranky's old place, and it is just full of awesome memorabilia.
Come and say hello to your old grandpappy Cranky. I'm back by popular demand to offer you a wealth of game-playing wisdom and other shit. K. Rool is gonna whip your ass this time, whippersnappers. I better take over before you embarrass yourselves. Team up, I've never heard such rubbish in my life! When I played, I was on my own! I had no fancy backup!
And it still hurts my throat to do that voice. Are you gonna say anything else, Cranky?
Pick a subject! I know everything about this game!
So we got Pirate Panic.
Try using your team throw at the start!
Lockjaw's Locker.
Below the letter K, you'll find a reward if you avoid the danger!
And I'm not doing any more because most of these hints are, quite frankly, useless. And I already know I'm doing everything in this game, plus this voice hurts to do.
I'm off to spend my tokens!
And it's basically the last time we'll speak to Cranky because I can't do that voice and most of his advice is useless. Anyway, on the next episode, we're going to go into Gangplank Galley. So until then, this is Version 2, signing out.